oceans cover a 3/4 of Earth's total surface. India has a coastline of more than 8,000 kilometers. Almost a 1/4 of our country's population, their lifestyles and livelihood is influenced by the dynamics of the ocean. One of the most vulnerable communities is of fishermen who are entirely dependent on the sea for their livelihood. Conventional fishing practices consume significant time and fuel, making fishing a low profit margin occupation. The Indian National Center for Ocean Information Services, or NCOIS, a premier autonomous institute under the Ministry of Earth Sciences of the Indian government, has a flagship program named Marine Fishery Advisory Services. This program harnesses ocean remote sensing satellite data to generate potential fishing zone advisories. The scientists identify the areas in the ocean where temperature and food availability is a perfect match for fish aggregation. Marine food chain depends on the blooms of the microscopic algae having chlorophyll inside it.
Chlorophyll content in the water indicates the vegetation in the oceans or the food availability in the oceans.
These blooms are usually sustained by processes such as upwelling. Upwelled waters have distinct oceanographic signature. This allows scientists to use satellite imagery of various parameters such as sea surface temperature, sea surface height, and chlorophyll to identify fertile areas in the ocean. The MFAS team at NCOIS processes all such data and brings them into Geographic Information System, or GIS. Advisories are prepared in the form of simplified maps and text. Text advisories are prepared in 8 coastal languages along with English and Hindi and provide information that can be utilized with or without GPS equipment.
These potential zone advisory information will be provided to fishermen by various communication modes.
These range from fax to smartphone apps, and users can choose the mode of their convenience.
एक सामान्य मोबाइल ऐप बनाई है, लेकिन उसकी ताकत इतनी है कि मछुआरा फिशिंग के लिए जब जाता है तो कहाँ जाना, सबसे ज़्यादा फिश जोन अच्छा कहाँ पर है, यानी एक मोबाइल ऐप पर सारी जानकारियाँ उपलब्ध।
అందువల్ల మాకి ఈ డీజిల్ శ్రమ ఖర్చు ఈ అలలెత్తు ఇవన్నీ తెలుసుకొని అంటేనే మాకి టైం కూడా కరెక్ట్గా మాకు తెలిసి వస్తుంది.
మీనిన ఇరువికే కేంద్ర సులభవాగి కండిడియో హాగె నమగే తెలుసుకొట్రు. ఇదర ప్రయోజనవన్న బోట్నవరు ప్రతినిత్యవు నోడ్కొండి హోగి ಪ್ರತಿನಿತ್ಯವು ಮೀನನ್ನು ಹಿಡಿದು ತಂದರು. ಇದರಿಂದ ಸುಮಾರು 60-80% ಒಂದು ಸಕ್ಸಸ್ಫುಲ್.
ಬ್ಲೂ ಇಕಾನಮಿ ಆನೆ ವಾಲೆ ಸಮಯ ಮೇ ಏಕ್ ಬಹುತ್ ಬಡಾ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರ ಬನ್ನೆ ವಾಲಾ.
ಆಸ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಇಸ್ ಗಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಅಪ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಬ್ಲೂ ಇಕಾನಮಿ, ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಹಾರ್ನೆಸ್ ಓಷನಿಕ್ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಸಸ್ಟೈನಬಲ್ ಮ್ಯಾನರ್. ಟು ಅಚೀವ್ ದಿಸ್ ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಆಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್, ಎನ್ಕೋಯ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಪೀಶೀಸ್ ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫಿಕ್ ಫಿಶರಿ ಅಡ್ವೈಸರೀಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಟ್ಯೂನಾ. The advisories are developed and improved with world-class research, including satellite telemetry. This is a pop-up satellite archival tag, and it has an antenna, a float, temperature, and depth sensors. It is used to study the movement and ecological preferences of the tuna fish. MFAS scientists utilize their understanding of the species behavior to make tuna PFZ advisories more reliable and user-friendly.
The main advantage of this potential fishing zone advisors is in terms of not getting the huge amount of fish catch, but in terms of the reduction in searching time for the fishing shoals.
Studies report that PFZ advisories help save thousands of liters fuel and relief for every fishing village, thus boosting profit, and by reducing emissions, help improve country's carbon footprint.
Potentially, fishery zone advisories will be further strengthened to reach more fishermen in the country.
Here, ekkada velthunnara?
Yaadu velthunnara?
Meeku chapalu ekkada dorukutundi telusa? Ikkada message undi chusara?
ఇగోన్స్ వాళ్ళు పట్టిన మెసేజ్ ఇది చూసి చేపలు ఎక్కడ దొరుకుతుంది మీకు తెలిసిపోద్ది.
అంటే ఇప్పుడు చేపలు పడే ప్రదేశం జీపీఎస్ పెట్టుకుని వెళ్ళిపోవచ్చా?
దీన్ని బట్టి దీన్ని జీపీఎస్ లో కొట్టుకుని వెళ్తే మీకు చేపలు ఎక్కడ దొరుకుతున్నాయో తెలిసిపోద్ది.
ఈ జీపీఎస్ తిన్న చేపలు పడే ప్రదేశానికి తిన్నగా వెళ్ళిపోవచ్చా?
ఇంతకు ముందులా చేపలు ఎక్కడ దొరుకుతున్నాయి చంద్రుడు అంతా గాలించే కంటే ఇప్పుడు చేపలు ఎక్కడ దొరుకుతున్నాయి అక్కడికే ఖచ్చితంగా వెళ్ళచ్చు.